So I think I'm Fauve Altman from State of the Dapps, and I think you've seen the title of this talk is From Oasis to Jungle, specifically for the Dapps. I felt like introducing this talk with 5 seconds of a very old cliche song. Welcome to the jungle! Welcome to the jungle. Is it? Great. So, some of you know State of the Dapps, some of you don't. State of the Dapps, I'll go over the evolution. So how did it start? When did it start? It started in 2015 with our founder, Joris Bontier, who's a Dapp developer himself. And was building Dapps and had friends who were building Dapps who'd been around since the very beginning of Ethereum, and was wondering, with all his friends building Dapps and himself, being like, where are all these Dapps gathered afterwards? Like, is it just your website, your pet project, your GitHub repo? And we don't know where to look at them, we don't know where to find them. So what did he decide to do was to set up a good old Google Sheet in 2015, where everything is gathered. It's still gathered into the Google Sheet. All of you can access it. It is open to the public. So it started with a Google Sheet, starting with a few Dapps that were there. Now, some of them from the very start are still active. Some just, you know, moved on to something else, new endeavors. I started with State of the Dapps in 2017, when it had not only a Google Doc sheets, but a very, very bright UI. And when I moved on it, I was not in a blockchain at that time. I was interested in it. I was interested in AI and IoT, and then blockchain, of course, and starting to hear a lot about Ethereum and wondered, what is Ethereum exactly? So when I started researching Ethereum early end of 2016, early 2017, one of the websites that came on popping up was State of the Dapps with that UI. And I was just, one day I decided, okay, I'm gonna research this, look into it. 300 about projects, 280 on this one. And I was just like, what is this? Is this a whole other world? It felt like this is a game. There's a name, my hearth, IRL with another name, and I just wanted in different colors. So, and then I started to look at who was the founder, who was behind it, who was the team behind it, and saw that they were looking actually for a community manager, a communication person, somebody that's not a techie, that can do social, that can play the dumb user for the developers to be like, well, that doesn't make sense for a user, let's rephrase these things. So I jumped on in 2017 in spring. And when I started, let's say 1st of June 2017, there were 325 projects. Today we are at 2,500 Dapps listed. That's a huge growth. People, it might be a bear market. We might all think that everything's quiet at the moment. It's not quiet. People are building, people are developing. So then we changed UI. We went fast forward, we needed to have a better UI. In saying a better UI, it's not only about the looks of it, it's about making it understandable for whoever that goes on the website. For the Dapp owners to know where their Dapp is, how their Dapp is rated, how it is looked at, the curation. So that's the kind of community role that we've taken upon, is to be there for the Dapp owners and for the potential users, and filter, curate. So we had badges at first to say who was compliant with MetaMask, who had a fairly strong profile, who had perhaps was like audited by Solidified at the time. We did badges and so forth. Then we moved on. We kept on enhancing the UI, which now looks like this, 2019. And we added more images, we added screenshots, we had added promotions also to kind of, you know, give a bit of a thumbs up to the good projects out there. What's a good project? It's, we select the good projects with the team, but also with what the community seems to be saying around, with the trends that keep on going around. We have a strict rule of not promoting Ponzi's and gambling for multiple reasons. How did the ecosystem grow? I'm gonna show you a few graphs. So, new Dapps per month have grown. You can see there's been quite a big growth in 2017. And if we look at it. December, January are generally calm months, but I don't consider this graph to be saying that it's been quite calm. It's been growing. Now, if we look at it, Dapps grow for Ethereum precisely per month. I'm showing this one because we've opened up to a few other platforms, blockchains, lately. So, a few statistics. At the moment, we have about 2,550 Dapps listed on our platform. In those 2,500, we might be missing a few. I haven't checked yet at the submissions that we've gotten about new Dapps. They'll come through me. I've been a bit jet lagged and yet get to go and vet a few projects and said, okay, so we might be missing 20 now. So about 6,000 have a smart contract deployed. 1,100 have a GitHub project. 542 are on Telegram and 332 on Discord chat. Remember last year about everybody was on Slack. Everybody was doing Slack, and then suddenly there was a big shift. Everybody went to Discord and Telegram, a few on Rocket Chat, but I don't know if that's still up. And about 800 have a blog. These numbers may be lacking or missing a few, because either what, the Dapp listed is just not updated, we're missing a few links, Dapp authors have not come up and sent us the new links that they have. I haven't had the time yet to go through almost 3,000 Dapps and update them. So the platform that I use, I think this is, give you an overview because we've opened up to a few other blockchains. So 2,300 on Ethereum, 215 on EOS, missing for sure, 62 on Steam, 14 on POA, 4 on GoChain, and Tron, well, we're not sure about adding Tron. We do have our reservations. I'm not going to delve into the details about it. If you want to have a talk about Tron, why it should be added, why we should open up to it, by all means, find me afterwards. But we're not yet convinced with the technology, with the team, with what they've been doing because of a few issues of copycats. Dapp categories. I think that's an obvious one by being in blockchain, being in the world of developers, which category is the one that is the most popular? It's games. Second one, well, obviously that's a big trend as well, is gambling, 372 gambling projects. Then high risks, Ponzi's, exit scams, if you want to call them, 223 on them. And finance, obviously, is a big one. Social is to be reworked. The numbers are going to change and shift a lot of the social ones into marketplaces because we did not have this category yet up to date on the website, which has been added now. Therefore, the 272 from social, are a few of them are going to move to marketplace, and this one is going to be a bit more accurate in a few days. The popular licenses, this is a bit, is 821 on MIT. GPL is the second one, the most popular one, proprietary, and Apache. Apache being less and less seen so far. And 175 that are undisclosed are most part because we just don't have the license. Either a GitHub repo is missing. It hasn't been undisclosed. It hasn't been disclosed, sorry. So project maturity. This one is one that really makes me happy to see that out of about, let's say, 2,000 Ethereum Dapps, 1,300 are live. That is great. These numbers have changed. A lot of the Dapps in the last year have moved to the mainnet and become live. You can now interact with way many more Dapps. A lot are in beta and prototype as well. Work in progress is a special one. Because work in progress, we have projects that stay in a work in progress status for more than a year. Some of them even 2 years. They stay quiet, they develop, they're under the radar, and then one day, boom, it's like, hi, we're live. We got all these Ethereum contracts on the mainnet, token contracts, here, let's update everything. So almost brand new. It's super cool to see when it changes, but sometimes we wonder, are you actually a working project in progress, or is it time for us to downgrade the status to, are you non-existent, are you stealth, what's up with that? So who's your audience? Or our audience on the website? About every month we get 160K visits, estimated, per month. It's a good visibility. The top searches from your audience, the users on our website, search into our search bar, is crypto, obviously. So we get a lot of requests about education. How can I build a Dapp? I want to build a Dapp. Where should I go to? Since we installed communication direct chat on the website. And a lot of these requests are, I want to learn about crypto. I want to learn about blockchain. I want to learn how to develop a project. A lot of the users actually on the website are not your developer already or Dapp author. There are a lot of people who are newcomers to the field. So that's a really good thing to see. It's growing. People are coming into it, are getting more and more curious about the field. The second one is FOMO, for the high amount of 225 Ponzi's that we have. So the FOMO trend, remember that one when FOMO 3D came out? Afterwards, it was just like a bunch of other copycats of FOMO. It's always, it always goes in trends. There's a hype, there's one that works well. Then afterwards, all the submissions of new Dapps that we receive are all from a copycat type. Oh, I'm going to do the same. I hope it's going to work as well. The category that are selected, well, again, an obvious one, it's games. The second one is gambling and social and finance. Those are the top four categories of searches, the top four with the most Dapps as well, and the types of projects we receive. So our highest ranking Ethereum Dapps. So the ranking system that we've established on the website is not a paid ranking. The ranking is based on multiple factors, being first one of the first. They all have a different value factor for putting them on the rank. So one of them is active users per unique source address in transactions to a Dapp contract. The second one is transaction volume. The third one, developer activity. Fourth, profile freshness and strength, which I will explain a little bit later on that one, which is a very subjective point to our website. Five, CTR, click-through rates. And six, user recommendations, which I'll show you as well afterwards. Where are your users? Well, quite obvious. We know the US is a very, very big market. Second one is China as well, and South Korea. We've seen a big boom and expansion with Korea developers market. A lot of Dapps come from there. They have great developers. They're a very energetic community, that's for sure. So on successful and high ranking Dapps, this is, we've chosen these Dapps. We consider them successful and high ranking from all the previous points I've given to you about the rank. Friends, fingers. So I apologize for some of the Dapp names. We do not get to choose the Dapp names. We can sometimes recommend to the Dapp authors, you might want to rename your Dapp to something that might be relatable to what your Dapp is actually doing. Or, you know, learn about the language and does it make sense in that language versus it does not make sense in it makes sense in your language versus it does not make sense in the translated language. So French Fingers is a very cool project because it helps startups and SMEs to start a crowd sale, like trusted crowd sale, and issue an ERC token directly, and there's no setup costs for them, and there's zero line of code that they need to do. So it's very easy onboarding for startups and SMEs to directly start a crowd sale. Kind of like a Kickstarter, but like really simple, surprisingly simple for the blockchain. Second one a lot of you must know is Status. Status, who is an old and steady project that's been around for quite a long time, with a great team, with a very active team as well. And they go from Dapp building to Dapp incubation now to chatting and to transactions. Status has you covered on so many points. Then let's talk about trends. In October 2017, early 2018, we had the boom of CryptoKitty. We all remember the collectible trends. That was last year's trend. It started with CryptoKitty, and then what happened? Every day, it was the only submissions we got were collectibles. We had crypto puppies, crypto titties, all sorts. Crypto titties is actually quite active still. That was an interesting one. I mean, cool designs, that's for sure. And So trends go on like this, and this is something that we get to see behind the scenes with having a good visibility with DAP authors and the community, is these type of trends. Like I said previously, the FOMO trend. One came out, FOMO 3D, it had some traction, everybody decided to release FOMO type of DApps. Then you remember the idle farming games, that as well. One came out, oh, good idea, let's just build idle farming games. Only idle farming games. We had the EuroCup. Only EuroCup dApps for sometimes. Trends happen, and it's quite cool to see that. There's a hype, one goes on, everybody does it, goes down, it quiets down, then we have more variety of dApps that are being built, and so forth. So in the DeFi trend, DeFi decentralized finance, which is the topic of the year at the moment, and is also the topic here at ETH Denver, Uniswap. Uniswap is a protocol for automated exchange on Ethereum, very simple to use. Compound, which I'm not sure if many people know of it, but also an interesting no-risk platform to have your assets on it. You put all your assets on Compound, and you earn interest for your holdings. Simple as that. Maker is here as well. And Maker has a booth upstairs, and I will let them answer to any questions of how they work and what they do, but a collateralized debt position portal. But the whole team is here and are a better place to, for sure, answer all your questions on what they do regarding DeFi. And there's Augur that has been around also for quite a long time, and it's a prediction market. I think they're one of the first actually to have been doing prediction markets. And I don't say that easily one of the first, because with all the dApps submissions that come through every day, which is about 5 to 15, and I see these generic terms, the first one in the world, revolutionizing. You're not revolutionizing. Other people have done it as well. Use other words. What does your dApp do? Explain it. You have a tagline, you have a description. Use words, use explanatory information, not just empty words. Decentralized on Ethereum, great, but this is a platform for Ethereum or EOS. Say what does your dApp do, because a quick overview, let's say with the 160 visits we get on the website, a user is gonna go on the dApp profile and is gonna wanna understand as fast as possible what your project do. And if you don't say what it does, then retention attention goes away. We're in a fast movement, the movement of social media. People want to know very fast. So the call to action to all of you is, if you have a dApp, send it to us if it's not listed already. If your dApp is listed on us, come and edit your dApp or improve it. There are many ways to do so. So as I was saying, there's the profile strength, which is taken into account for the rankings on our website, is you can go and improve your dApp, and it'll tell you at which percentage of strength your profile is. And it will guide you to what is missing. Are you missing an icon image, a logo, a product image? Your license is missing. Let's say with the numbers I was saying before, 50 licenses given. Well, it might be actually 200 licenses are given, but you just didn't submit it. We don't have it, or we can't find the information. And it takes a lot of time to go through almost 3,000 dApps and be like every section to update. So we want to prompt these interactions with dApp authors, and it does not need to be your dApp as well. If you see something's missing about one of your favorite dApp, send it over to us. You'll be speaking with me. I'll be interacting with you. Let's just update, and you know, the higher your profile is, the fuller it is, the higher it will rank. So that's about it for State of the Dapps. And if any of you have any questions that you can ask me, or you want to talk about dApps, you're building a dApp, you are searching for resources, you can come and speak to us. We're always available for the community, and we want to see the community grow, and we want to see people actually using more and more dApps. Thank you.